Ciao everybody, Caterina here. Welcome to my kitchen. Well, this weekend is Mother's Day, and I am so happy to be able to say to you that I will be having my beautiful mother for Mother's Day. And I thank God every time I'm able to say those words. And one dish that I'm going to be preparing is ravioli stuffed with potatoes and a ricotta and black kale sauce. Delicious. Now let's get started. You're gonna need your mixer with the dough hook, 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 3 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of kosher salt, 5 large eggs, 2 egg yolks. Once you see the dough gathering like this around the hook, you know it's ready. However, it still needs to be kneaded for 5 minutes, but I'm gonna let the machine do that. We're just going to move this down. I am going to wrap it up in plastic wrap and let it rest for 40 minutes at room temperature. We're going to start with the stuffing for the ravioli. About an hour ago, I boiled 3 yellow potatoes. I let them cool, I peeled them, and now I'm going to put them through the ricer. To my potatoes, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of kosher salt. Some black pepper, a little bit of nutmeg, 3/4 cup of fresh ricotta. Two tablespoons of Parmigiano Reggiano. Before I continue, I'm just going to give this a really good mix. 1 garlic clove crushed, and a handful of chopped parsley. The zest of 1/2 lemon. Just a little splash of olive oil, just to soften it up a little bit. Now I'm just going to give it a thorough mix. So my pasta dough is ready. I'm gonna put a little bit of semolina on my workplace. Now you do need semolina instead of flour because it won't stick to your dough. I'm going to cut this in 4. Beautiful. We're going to start with level 1. Now the first time that the dough goes through, I'm just going to overlap it and put it through again, just to make sure that all the air holes are gone. My favorite thing to do is to make pasta. Okay, now I'm on level 5. Now, because I'm going to be making ravioli, I normally stop at 6, but I'm not going to. I'm going to stop at 7. It needs to be thinner. My little scooper, I'm just going to scoop and place it along the side here. Now what I'm going to do is I have some scrambled egg white here, and all I'm going to do is go along the bottom here. This is going to be the glue that's going to adhere the pasta together. Now I'm going to put some on the sides. Okay, between. Now we're going to put it along the top here. See how easy this is? Brings me right back to my childhood. I remember on Sundays, my parents would be in the kitchen making this recipe or pastas, lasagna. They always made their own pasta. Very gently, I'm just going to fold it over. Right over. And I'm just going to, with my hands, as carefully as I can, I'm going to remove all the air. There. Of course, you can just use a knife, but I have this very decorative pastry cutter, so I'm just going to use the pastry cutter. There. Okay, so I'm just going to cut down the sides and down this way. Okay, I'm just going to place them on parchment paper and allow them to dry a little bit before we cook them. My first batch is done. Now we're going to start with the second batch. Okay, I'm going to put semolina on my work surface and we're going to start with the second. Okay, now we're down to the last batch. How wonderful, there's nothing like homemade pasta. Now this recipe made approximately 60, we're rolling over. Make sure to take out all the air pockets. It's a beautiful pasta. Cut down. And now get me doing this. And we're done. 60 gorgeous, delicious ravioli for a beautiful, special lady, my gorgeous mama. I'm going to prepare a lovely sauce. And we're just going to make a little bit for ourselves, just to taste it for you. Now I'm going to be placing the remainder of these ravioli in the refrigerator for Sunday. However, if you wanted to use them maybe in a week or two, these freeze beautifully. The only thing I would do is I would divide them up in plastic wrap, then place them in a freezer bag, and then I would put them in the freezer, but flat, and then remove them the day before and allow them to thaw in the refrigerator. We're gonna start with the sauce now. It's so simple and delicious. A splash of olive oil, one chopped shallot, and we're just gonna let it saute for a few minutes. Now we're gonna add half a cup of speck. We're gonna let this saute together. Two bunches of Tuscan kale, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut it up. So this is all wonderful flavor here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a quarter cup of white wine to deglaze the pan. Okay, now that the alcohol has evaporated from the white wine, we can add the Tuscan kale. And to add one cup of chicken stock. And I'm just gonna let this cook for approximately 10 minutes. It's been 10 minutes, I'm going to add a knob of butter, 2 ounces of Parmigiano Reggiano, some black pepper, and the water's boiling, it has been salted. Now I'm going to add 10 of the ravioli to cook. It'll only take a few minutes. Once they rise to the top, you know they're cooked. It took exactly 3 minutes. They're cooked beautifully. Now I'm going to place them in the sauce. And I'm going to let them simmer in the sauce for approximately a minute. I love my Parmigiano Reggiano, so I'm going to just sprinkle a little bit for my sweetheart. Taste this for you with pleasure. I know that my beautiful mother is going to love this. Absolutely delicious. I want to thank you so much for joining me today. I want to wish you all a very happy Mother's Day. to all you mothers, grandmothers, great-grandmothers, paw mothers. And I hope that on Sunday your day will be spectacular, as I am going to do my very best to make my beautiful mother, my queen, the kindest, caring, God-fearing, honest, sweetest, nurturing, funny, and I never ever heard her say a bad word about anybody. She's an angel from heaven, and I thank God for her every day. I prepared a few photographs at the end of my segment. I hope you enjoy them. God bless you all, and it's Caterina from my home to yours.
Mamme si amano, ma ti amano di più. E così piccolo io avrei affrontato il mondo, vuoi chi si avvicina e chi la tocca. E che parole dolci come quelle torte al forno, che veniva l'acquolina in bocca. Mi rimboccava fino al naso le coperte, se pioveva avevo un po' paura. E mi tuffavo nel suo letto a braccia aperte, ad ogni tuono forte mi stringeva. Le mamme sognano, le mamme invecchiano, le mamme si amano.